The current state of eastern barred bandicoots is they're extinct outside of fences, so they only remain on the mainland in captivity or behind feral proof fences, as well as islands. We are at Mount Rothwell, which is Victoria's largest pest-free ecosystem.
Yeah, so what we're doing here at Mount Rothwell is we're undertaking a genetic rescue of eastern barred bandicoots. So unfortunately, the eastern barred bandicoot is extinct in the wild on mainland Australia, but there's still populations of them in the wild in Tasmania. And currently at Mount Rothwell, there is a population of around about 300 to 400 of those eastern barred bandicoots.
Over so many years of captive breeding of such a small sample size, there were some genetic flaws identified. So we had undershot jaws, a lower breeding rate, and decreased fitness.
What we're aiming to do with the genetic rescue is essentially restore the genetic variation of the population by taking some Tasmanian eastern barred bandicoots and crossbreeding them with Victorian eastern barred bandicoots to increase that genetic variation. We know from some of our research that that genetic variation is going to limit this species into the future, and that's why we need to increase it. We're now at the F3 generation, so three generations past that initial crossbreeding trial, and so we're just really assessing how that crossbreeding has worked, both from a fitness perspective to make sure that they're all reproductively fit and that there's no issues there, but also from a genetic level to try and understand exactly what happens when you cross two different populations that have been isolated for a long period of time, to see what effect that has at the genomic level.
Currently our involvement is breeding and housing probably the largest population of mainland eastern barred bandicoots in Australia. We probably have about 70 to 80% of the entire population here. And we are the first to be applying this outcrossing program to our site. And in the future, we hope to eventually spread all these animals across all the different sites. So ideally, we want to reach the population of about 3,000. And that number has been identified as the point where genetic decline is decreasing. It sort of stabilises.
Genetic rescue was first implemented in Australia in the mountain pygmy possum. Was a program that I led back in 2010 and 11. We found that it was very successful as a method of population recovery, and the program here at Mount Rothwell in the eastern barred bandicoot was taking that next step and seeing how it worked in another small marsupial, making sure that we had no complications, and making sure that it was as effective as what it was with the Mount Buller mountain pygmy possum. From here, what we hope to see is that the eastern barred bandicoot that has now been outbred, or the genetic variation has been restored, will then start filtering these bandicoots out into other conservation reserves and other areas where they've been released on the mainland of Australia. It's in terms of the conservation of the Victorian eastern barred bandicoot, it's a real step forward in protecting that species from many of the threats that will persist into the future.